Now that we have all the back-end pieces installed, we have Ruby, Ruby Gems, Rails, and MySQL. Now we need to have a web server. Now, of course, we need a web server when we're in production, right? When we put this out there on the internet for people to access, they're going to come with their browser, they're going to type in a URL, and it's going to connect to our web server to return a request to them. And that web server will then, in turn, talk to our Rails application to figure out what it ought to return. Well, the same thing is going to be true in development. We're going to follow the exact same process. We're going to have a browser connecting to a web server, talking to our Rails application. So the question is, which server do we choose for our development environment? Let's look at the main choices. There's Apache, either version 1 or 2. There's a lot to recommend Apache. It's the most popular web server out there. Secondly, it ships with macOS 10, so you already have it installed. In fact, if you go to System Preferences, pick Sharing, and then turn on Web Sharing, you'll be turning on Apache, so that Apache will then be listening for web requests and returning web pages. In my PHP tutorials, that's what we use to be able to return PHP pages. There's also a piece of software for Apache called Passenger, which is referred to sometimes as Mod Rails, and that's an Apache module which allows Apache to talk to Rails so that we have an interface between Apache and Rails. That's definitely a great combination, and I would say that probably the vast majority of Rails-driven websites out there in production are using Apache 2 with Passenger. But there's some other choices we should look at. There's Nginx. Nginx is a new competitor to Apache. It's very popular, gaining quickly in popularity, has a lot of the same features that Apache has, which is that it has a lot of features, lots of configuration options. And then there are some lighter weight options. There's Lighty, Mongrel, and last of all, Webbrick. And when I say lighter weight, what I mean is they don't have all of the features. They don't necessarily have the same robustness that Apache and Nginx have, but they do have more speed. And that's what they do. They really try and focus on speed. Leave out the features, focus on the speed. And in more advanced setups, a lot of times you'll see people sort of mixing and matching and combining these different web servers to be able to respond to requests as quickly as possible, but still have all of those features. So I want to focus on the last one there, Webbrick. This is probably one that you've never heard of. Webbrick is a very, very simple web server that ships with Rails. So when we did the Rails installation, we also installed Webbrick at the same time. Now, I've tried many of these web servers, both in production and for development, and I recommend that you stick with Webbrick. It's pre-installed, pre-configured to use it. It's just right there waiting for it to use, and it's just a very, very simple web server that just does one thing and does it well. Takes your browser request, talks to your Rails application, returns the results. So because it's that easy and there's no configuration involved, that's definitely what we want to start with for this essential training. It's just to use the one that's built in. But I wanted you to know about these others to know that you can certainly try them. You can try them both for your development environment or for your production environment. But we're going to be sticking with the built-in Webbrick.